We couldn't resist the opportunity this week to bring you live and on location to the Quad at Hobart and William Smith Colleges. On April 2nd, with 75 degree temperatures, students poured on the Quad from all corners of campus. Classes met outside, students tossed the frisbee, kicked the soccer ball, and soaked in the spring sun. So we hope you enjoy another edition of Meet the Campus here at Hobart and William Smith Colleges.
From Hobart and William Smith Colleges, this is Meet the Campus with John Hebe.
This week, we'll speak with the former governor of Vermont, Howard Dean, visit the office of William Smith Dean, Cerri Banks, and sit down with Hobart Jr., John Monaghan. But join me this week and every week for Meet the Campus with me, John Hebe, the most powerful name in news. You never know who will show up on campus. This week, former governor of Vermont, Howard Dean, past chair of the Democratic National Party and candidate for president, visited campus to deliver a lecture on the politics of a new generation.
You have an incredible facility. You are right on the shore of one of the most beautiful lakes in America, and you have a great college president. What else do you need? Yeah, these are great. These are high-powered students. They ask great questions. They understand. They know what they're talking about. It's really been a delight. I've met a lot of students over the day, from the freshmen all the way up to graduating seniors. It's been terrific. Well, there are two things that I think happen when I come to a place like this. The first, of course, is they hear me speak, and that's all great and everything. But the educational function for me is, I think, as important as the educational function for the students. I learn a lot from not being in Washington and listening to what people are interested in. And I think they learn from each other when they hear people stand up and say things that they might not ordinarily say in class.
As the Dean of William Smith College and an Assistant Professor of Education, Cerri Banks is passionate about her students. Her work focuses on social justice, equity, and culture.
You know, I'm an academic. I can't do anything in three words. So I'm going to say a few more. It's first the students. They like to be stimulated intellectually. They are smart and aggressive in really great ways, and they have a deep sense of community and care for each other. I'm always amazed at not only what they're able to accomplish, but their spirit and their generosity and their real love for this place. And I think that is what inspires me most to work hard to be really good at my work. For me, if it doesn't come from the students, it doesn't matter. Their success is the only way by which I can measure my own success.
One of only eight finalists from New York State for the prestigious Truman Scholarship in Public Service, Hobart Jr. John Monaghan plans on attending law school and hopes that his legal training will help him for his future plans of gay and lesbian political advocacy.
In order to have successful student involvement, you have to tap into really engaged groups of students, which I think we definitely have here at HWS.
I'd say academically, my interests would be one in gay and lesbian politics, in political organizing, and two would be constitutional law. My goal has changed from going to law school with the intent of practicing law to going to law school as a stepping stone to getting involved in legislative strategy and examining some of the tools and tactics to get public policy through a legislature like the federal government or a New York State government. I had done mock trial in high school, and we didn't have a mock trial team, so I thought I'd give debate a shot. It was pretty nerve-wracking at first in my first year, but I stuck it out and gave it a shot, and then now 3 years later, I had just gone to Turkey over winter break to compete in the World University's debating championship, and I'm going to be going to Nationals in Denver in a few weeks.
Thanks for watching, and join me next week for another edition of Meet the Campus. Thanks for stopping by.